Hello, 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 everybody. It's Shapoopi here, and I'm finally back with some more City Skylines. And we are no longer in Baboobla City. We are starting a new clean slate, a new city, and I don't know if you watched one of my other videos. I don't even know which video I was talking about what I want to do, but what I wanted to do was basically just start anew, you know? I felt like Baboobla City, my other City Skylines, you know what, we'll call that part season one or something like that. And this is city number two, season two. And yeah, because I felt like that was a good introduction back to City of Skylines since I haven't played it in such a long time. And with this city, I want to take it slow. I want to make things deliberate, you know? I want to take the time to really plan out what I'm doing. Oh, that's great. And we can't even see any of this stuff. But yeah, so we are on the islands map, and this is also being played on a new computer which has a lot higher processing power, so things should look a lot smoother, a lot prettier, and yeah. So why don't we just get started? Let's see, how do we want to do this? How do we want to do this? I'm trying to think how I want to do this. I figure I want to have this area down here being like a downtown core. I was figuring I might even pull out this highway later on and push it to the edge. And then maybe on this side we can make an airport and a cargo terminal. That way it's not far out of downtown, but it's far enough so that traffic isn't insane. It's already 2016! but we'll also need to plan out where we're gonna put our industry and things like that. And so you know what? We'll just start building down this way. And I am going to try and be a lot more strict, more disciplined with, or maybe not strict, I should say. I want to be, what's the word I'm looking for? I want to be not afraid to destroy things that I've placed down, and, you know, not be afraid to clear out the land or roads and replan everything. And you know what? Since this is closer, we'll have it like this. So they're not too far away, but they're not too far from the electricity either. And that's connected. Nice. And oh, we need to bring the water out this way. There we go. That is good for now. And let's speed that up so we get some people moving in. Nice. So we got people moving in. And we definitely need to set this budget so that we do not run ourselves into the red. And we can also bring down this electricity too, since we got so many windmills going on. We will definitely need to start putting out some industry. There we go. And we'll move that away from the city center. And unfortunately, since it is a new city, we don't know where the natural resources are. But a good way to tell is usually the difference in color of the land. So you can see this outline here. This is either fertile land or oil or something like that. There's some sort of natural resource below. And I also don't have all of my mods and assets and things like that. I wanted this to be a little bit of a cleaner, more vanilla experience. And yeah, looks like things are going pretty well so far. And I know this is very grid-like at the moment, but that will definitely change once we start getting new roads and we start actually getting settled everything where it should be, or at least where I want it to be. And now the water pipes are going to be just like this, every which way. It's going to be a total grid. That's just for cost efficiency and stuff like that. But oh, I'm so excited. I've been playing a little bit of City Skylines by myself because I just been wanting to play it, and I didn't want to play over the city that we made together. And I also did not want to I did actually play a little bit on the city that we made together, Babooba City, because I felt like, you know what, just to finish and tie up that city, we would I would just do a time lapse and just show you, like, try and finish up the city, get it to like 100,000, and then sort of ship it off and do a voiceover, and then quickly get started on this one, because I didn't really fall in love with that city, if you know what I mean. Little hamlet, landfill, medical clinic, elementary school, awesome. Healthcare and elementary education. All right, that looks good. Looking good. So that means we're gonna need to get. Garbage taken care of very quickly. And I'm definitely thinking these islands out here would be perfect for a landfill, since these things are so hard to get rid of and move and things like that. And I hate garbage. It's always such a huge issue. This has double the capacity, I think, right? Yeah, but we don't need that big one just yet. And since education is important, we will actually put one down early to start building up that. And now let's see. How are we gonna organize this? So this is definitely going to be industrial. And we can definitely have two streets driving down this way to sort of block out the industry from maybe like the residential and stuff like that. Looks like okay, we can move up the budget for these things then. We could probably scooch that up a little bit too. And that should be good. Yes, sweet. Did we get any new roads? We did. We got medium roads and we got large roads as well. Okay, that's good. So that will definitely help us arrange the city. But we're gonna need money to actually do any of that. So let's see. How much is that? That's $8,000. Ooh. Maybe we'll just drive it down along. Not so far, but far enough. Traffic's not a problem. Very nice. Oh, I'm so excited. City of Skylines is such a fun game. Such a fun game. There we go. Just making sure that those excuse me. Making sure that those houses become their full block rather than just the tiny blocks because of the power lines. Oops, what was that? What did they just tell me? Worthy village, districts, policies, a new area, agriculture, specialization, forestry, and do we get to see now where the natural resources are? Yes. So this is fertile land. This is going to be farmland. So definitely down this way will be farmland. We'll have to figure out how we're going to bring in trains. Looks like there is oil down that way. Oil also down this way. Okay. Now I'm not sure how I feel about having so much farmland directly next to, because if this was going to be our downtown, usually the suburbs are outside and then they don't usually have so much. But I mean, we also wouldn't have too much farmland now, would we? Unless we just make this whole island the downtown. And like I was saying earlier, we push the highway on the outskirts. Huh. We'll have to see. But since we have thrown down some of this already, let us start building down this way. Now we won't do the whole land because that wouldn't be very cool. But at the same time, it's also kind of wasteful. But like I said, before, I will not be afraid to delete and restart and try again, because this is a new city, a new Shapoopi. We are gonna do this the right way. Now with country roads, they are very often very long, very straight, and there are the occasional intersections, but they're usually just four-way stops. There isn't too much traffic on them, so they can do that. So I think having this one road in here is okay, and every other road will intersect it like that, like so. And let's see, how do we want to do this section here? Should we still try to go for the straight, even though it's a little bit strange? And we'll start plopping that down there. And we'll zone this off quickly and set that to agriculture. Awesome. Let us see how we are setting up the city so far. Okey-dokes. I mean, this entire side here could definitely be a suburb. This area quite over here could be the entire downtown because there is actually quite a lot of space over this way. And you know what? To sort of. You need more money. Dang it. We'll quickly zone this for now. Just to satisfy the demand. Pull in some more of this blue stuff here. Water availability is doing great. Garbage doing great. Healthcare, okay. Ooh. We need a fire department. Let's speed this up. Let's get some money up in this city. Yay, yay. And then we don't need these power lines anymore. Very, very redundant power lines. And I think I'm okay with this. I think we might actually have to change this into a what do you call those? Roundabouts? And then, yeah. Because what I want to do is I want to convert this into a large road to sort of remind myself that this is going to be like a main road and then I'm going to generate suburbs from there. Okay, we got $4,000. Let us start building some suburbs. Now, would we actually, could we, I want to fit something in there, but I feel like that's unreasonable. You wouldn't normally do that. And if you were to draw a road here, they would probably disconnect that. But building out a cul-de-sac like that wouldn't be too unreasonable. And then probably, you know what, we could extend these out as well. I feel like one of these should connect. There's a nice little suburb. Nice little neighborhood. I mean, they don't usually have any sort of plant. Oh, we need more power. Budget? Sorry if you guys were like screaming at your screens, like, Shapoopi! You got no power! And I think we should be. Oh no, we're just under, and we don't got enough money for it. We will save up for that. Tiny town, reach population of 1,200, landscaping, parks, paths, canals, plazas, and awesome stuff. Let's throw down an extra windmill. I think we're good now. perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. We need to hit 2200. Awesome. We got one elementary school. Not cutting it. We need a police department. We'll throw it down on the main road. And then we also need fire. Oh, that's not fire. 560 a week. Can we cut it? I think we can cut it. Now this is looking weird to me. I feel like maybe that should be conjoined. I mean, it seems most logical, right? I'm trying to make different patterns. It just doesn't seem right. Let's see. Right? And then connect that up here. I mean, it's because I want cul-de-sacs, but there are very often side streets like this that just sort of venture through the city. And we can always extend this out. Something that goes parallel. Oh, I was wondering, I'm like, why can't I build it? Oh, it's because you ain't got no money. Man, we are totally hurting for money. And no power? Damn, sons. Not enough money. Oh my gosh. Can we up it a little bit more? No, we can't. Okay, so we'll just leave it like that. And I definitely think this would be cool to line the farm with windmills. I mean, but the thing is they don't like windmills. Oh, and we gotta up water treatment too. I don't remember it being such a struggle for electricity and things like that. There we go. And we will save for another one. Boomtown! Transport, recycling, recreational use, lots of other stuff, bus depots. Oh, and the water turbine. Perfect. But we don't actually have any location that we can make use of that. So that's great. That's great. There we go. A nice little windmill farm. And you know what? We should also maybe just arrange these a little bit more nicely. And it's not connected. We'll place another one. Oh, that's why we had so much money. I was like, how come we could place down so many farms? Well, that's because... Now, if we turn this into a roundabout, this won't be in the center anymore. And everything that we've lined that up with will be off. So that's great. Just great. Let's see, what shall we improve next? Oh, you know what? We can actually buy the next plot. I feel like this plot would be best, and then this one, and then this one. Just because this is a little bit awkward right now. There we go. Now, which road are we gonna make into? Now, we could definitely drive that road in. And this one as well. I'm trying to think about which ones we should upgrade to large roads. And what would make the city look best? But I mean, at the same time, it's a little too early for that. Do we need any more industry? Okay, that looks okay. Touch that up. And why don't we just zone that as well? Dezone this little bit here and this little bit here. Just to space out from the garbage. I mean, I don't think anyone wants to live next to garbage. Not enough money. Oh, speed this up. Come on. Give me the money. I don't want to be waiting. That's an ugly, ugly, ugly curve. No, that's still not quite as nice as I wanted that to be. Maybe I need to pull it further. Or I need to pull it from up higher. Yeah, that's pretty nice. And then we could have a nice... pull in. Like so. Pretty cool. If I do say so myself. And I do say so myself. And let's zone that up. And then we will need to upgrade that highway to be noise proof. And let's bump these up to 100%. Take care of those water problems. So we're doing just okay now. Garbage, we're handling it-ish. Fire safety, handling it-ish. Education is not doing so hot. And let's hope this one can cover this entire area. Yes! Except for that little bit. Oh man, that's unfortunate. And we're gonna need a cemetery. Now, where are we gonna put this? Could be nice out by the farms. You know, a little bit away from the city. Somewhere quiet. Oh, and we can finally see the elevation now. So the cool thing about this thing is that it kind of helps you to... I've heard some tips that people use the elevation to figure out how they're going to plan their city. Since this is elevated a little bit, they'll have like the suburbs around here-ish. And try to make use of the flatter land. But it's not a huge concern since the elevation isn't so severe. But like, we could definitely build... You know what? Maybe we'll pull in the highway closer to this edge since this side is higher. Or maybe we will have the highway higher up. I don't know. Oh wait, what did that tip say? Oh no. Terrain heights view shows avoid building canals from high to low ground as they can easily cause flooding. Oh, that's not helpful. What do you need? We need water pumping station. And you need sewage treatment. Does that hook up automatically? No, it doesn't. Why would it? Of course not. All right. And alright, so what I was building here earlier was I was trying to... I didn't want to build this straight across. I wanted it to have a slight curve. There we go. And then we build a cross like so. And then we lower it back down. I thought that was a nice little road through the city. A little bitty. And okay, since this is becoming a little bit of an issue, let's throw down that roundabout. And actually, I think we might need to move over this road as well. Even though it's so nicely placed. Not in the center of my city. let's see. So where are we gonna build this? So 10. Oh, in case you guys don't know how to build a roundabout. Or a nice roundabout. You just measure out 10 units, 10 units, 10 units from the center of one point, get your curve tool, and draw a curved road from each point. And I know what you're saying, this is a small road, but it's easier with a small road because of how it counts the units for you, and it can show you how you've drawn it. And there you got your circle. Actually, these two I did a little bit wrong. There we go. Perfect. And then you can delete these center roads, and then you can upgrade it to whatever size road you wanted. But again, best to have them going one way. And we can join that up. I'm not actually sure which way this road is traveling. But I think it's okay because they figure it out on their own. So they'll have to travel in this way. This is weird. I think the other direction is better. Or it doesn't matter. Looks like it doesn't matter to them. Distance is too short. What are you talking about? So you know what? We'll just cut through there like that. And we will also delete that road. Draw it out like that. Delete that road. Draw it out like that. And then this road, we can get rid of that. And attached like that. Oh no, that's a one-way road. We didn't want it to be a runway. Yeah, that's a problem. See, that's what I was seeing, because if they want to go out, they have to get into the right lane. So we'll have to actually No, I want it going in the other direction. How do I change the direction? Damn it. Oh, dang it. Oh, look at what a nice little circle that is. Oh my gosh, that's nice. let's see. Let's get this straight tool again. Let's try it one more time. 10 units. 10 units. 10 units. 10 units. And why don't we take the one-way road and we'll draw it ourselves in the direction that we want it. And hopefully, this way. Yes. Success. We can attach that. We can take the highways. Attach it correctly. Attach that up. Attach that up. And then we can also attach this up. Right. Yeah. Aww, it didn't do it. Yeah. Perfect. Nice. Now hopefully this corrects traffic a bit. And we were gonna upgrade this road as well, since there's so much traffic along here. And this one as well. So a lot of houses are being deleted in the process, but that is okay. All in the name of improving people's lives. Oh, it's because there's a fire, we can't upgrade it. And this one has a school on it. We will just scooch this aside. Now an elementary school right on a heavy traffic road, I don't think I want that. Or near the roundabout. So we'll actually just... actually, on a main road, it might not be terrible. Or maybe we just want it near a main road, like right here. It fits in nicely. So if parents were dropping off their kids, you know, they could get there really quickly, but they wouldn't have to drive insanely far. Awesome. Awesome, Blossom. There we go. And they are requesting more industry, and we can do that for them. We can throw down a whole bunch of agriculture. And that's I'm okay with those being... Actually, if we get small heavy roads or something like that, we'll throw those down here. But I think I'm okay with that being like that for now. And we'll just connect that there. Or maybe we'll connect it in a few places. Excuse me. Now, I don't want it to be in too many places is the thing, because I don't want this road to become super congested. And I don't want to upgrade these to heavy revenue avenues or anything like that. But I think this outside one might be okay to do that. Oops. Let's redo that one. There we are. Like so. And then we'll probably get rid of these roads here. We'll need to move this landfill site. I'll actually place two down this way. We'll empty this one so that we can move that and readjust these roads. Actually, you know what? What we could do is actually just draw it up and around it. That's not nice. But it's what we got for now. I want this to be a nice curve. There, that's a little bit better. And yeah, so this city is definitely going to have to, I'm going to try to make it look a lot nicer. Let's actually, you know what, to consolidate our intersections a little bit. We will drive these roads like so, so that they funnel into one intersection on this main avenue. That way it reduces, you know, the traffic just a scooch. Let's see how we want to do this area here. I'm thinking this could be like in a warehouse outlet mall. Just like so. Oh, and we're gonna need to get the water out. Oh no, we need a cemetery. Almost nailed it. Unfortunately, we did not. And now, where are we gonna put this cemetery of ours? I mean, I don't want it really in the city, in the suburbs, all too much. But you know what? Why not? I mean, here's an okay place. Not enough money? What are you talking about? Busy town, 4200, level 4 unique buildings, free public transport policies, lots and lots of roads, and hospitals and large police stations and things like that. Awesome. Now let's see, how is our city doing so far? Oh, looks like there is a lot of traffic. So let's get rid of that road there. A redundant intersection, and we'll just move that over there like that. Let's see if that improves traffic. I mean, it should. And you know what we probably could also do? We could probably elevate this roundabout so that we can have traffic flowing underneath that is already in the city, and traffic that is in coming from outside the city can funnel in that way. But so far, guys, I'm liking our new city, you know? I feel like we're taking our time. Things are looking a little bit better, you know? Man, do I say you know a lot? And nice. Now we got a nice little cemetery here. Are there seagulls here? Is it because of the garbage? Extend that just a little bit. Too far. And we still got very, very high demand. Huh. Because we do need to also have non-agricultural industry. So what I'll do is down this way. Now we won't build this area here because I do not want, if you were driving into the city, I would not want you to see, all you to see is factories and things like that. We'll keep a buffer zone of sorts. Let's see, tree with leaves, and let's, what is it, the plus button, I think? Control plus? How do I... how do I increase the brush size? Is it shift plus? I don't know. But we will have a buffer zone of trees along this way. And those are not even the right trees. Disaster. Oh, and we got no power. So let's add a few more windmills down this way to our little windmill farm. And even more over this way here. All the green energy, guys. Man, that is so cool. And they don't have power still. So let's actually just zone this area right here. Hopefully something will build in between. And that will transmit the energy.
Yes! Yes!
we could actually stick a park in here. Or we could just plant some trees. We could put some essential services. And yeah. Nice. Now I'm not loving this all too much. I mean, this is definitely a tiny side street. So you know what? We will just upgrade that. Because it is kind of an artery road. At least for the industry area. So it would make sense if that road was thicker. But this road definitely will not be made thicker. Well, actually, you know what? It could be. Since it is connecting to this artery road. And there are thicker streets traveling in this direction. Aw, man, are you serious? I can't upgrade that because this is in the way here. So you know what we'll have to do? We'll have to take it out just a little bit further. Turn off snapping. So we can give it that little bit extra room here. And then drive it down. There we go. And so it can't be. Like that. Can we scooch this over a little bit? We can. So that doesn't look as strange. Nice. And why couldn't we upgrade this road here? Did we just forget about that? Nice. Nice. Now we got some main streets going on. And we're looking pretty good, guys. Alright, so this is empty, and we can just plop that back. I don't know what we're doing with this road anymore. I'm thinking we should just drive the traffic on this main road here. But let's make it a little bit more attractive, if you will. There we go. Now it's a nice-ish curve. Now, traffic is going to be a huge problem with this industry section area, but I don't know if I said this earlier. It kept coming up, but then I kept getting sidetracked, so I kept forgetting to mention it. But I'm going to try and not do what I did last season with every episode and say, oh, we got a problem, we'll deal with it next time, and then never actually deal with it. We are going to deal with the problem before the episode ends. Okay, guys? At least that's my resolution. I'm gonna try and combat my bad habit of just leaving the issue till next episode, in which I then forget and never deal with. Okay, so now we can actually upgrade to some higher to some better facilities. We don't actually need a hospital. We're doing great on that. Oh, we need schools though. We definitely need schools. And these are assets. They're double the size. Should we do it? I mean, we're doing okay, but we could always be doing better. No, I don't want the high school across from the cemetery. I feel like a whole bunch of hooligans would just, you know, they wouldn't be respectful. So we'll put it on a mainish street. There, making all the people happy. And now we can actually zone a little bit more residential. Now we won't zone it out too far. And we'll, why don't we just bring that up now? That is very, very straight. We will fix that. But you know what, guys? I'm gonna do exactly what I said I wouldn't do. We'll deal with it next time. Alright, guys, we are getting close to 1 hour, so I'm gonna close out this episode. I hope you guys had a good time starting our new city. Oh, and I don't know what we're gonna name it, but we will have to name that as well next time. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys are excited as I am. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time. So bye bye for now.